From Digital Road Films, and today we're going to do a tutorial on mail on our Mac. Let's go down to the very bottom, okay, and click on Dock and open up the mail icon. Let's do a few things first. Let's go up in the mail preference section, click on that, and we're going to see a whole bunch of different icons pop up right here. Let's go to General as our first one. And we're going to set check for new messages every 5 minutes. Okay, we can do any number of one things that we'd like, and we can do it manually, but we can always check for messages anytime. And a new message sound, I use ping. Okay, you can use glass. That's a nice sound too. Well, let's keep it on glass for now. All right, now let's go over to junk mail. Okay. I would enable junk mail filtering. Make sure you got a check mark there. And also on the dot, unmark as junk mail, but leave it in my inbox. Who knows who it's from? Sometimes I get things that are marked as junk mail, and it's from friends. So it's just the way the junk mail filtering works sometimes. The following types of messages are exempt from junk mail filtering. So make sure those are all checked, each one of those boxes. And then this one, too, is checked. Trust junk mail headers, all right? We want to go into fonts and colors. Lucida Grand 14 is something I use in the mailbox font. I use other fonts elsewhere. Let's go to select, okay, on mailbox font. And I have it at Lucida Grande 14. Let's change the size. Let's show you what we can do. And I changed it to 10. You see how small it got, all right? Let's go back to that other little drop-down menu. And let's change it back to 14. That's a better size for me. I like that. So that'll work out for me. And you can do a lot of things. You could change the font family. You can do a typeface change as well. Okay, let's go out of that particular little box. Okay, and go back into our preferences. Let's go to the next one called composing. Message format. I like the rich text. Okay, you can do a plain text. Rich text works nice. And check spelling. I like to do it as I type. You can do it when you click and send or never. Automatically CC myself when I send something. If you'd like to do that, just put a check mark on that box. Okay. If not, you don't need to have it there. All right. Signatures. This is something I like to have. I think it's fun. You can add a signature to the bottom, okay, of your Comcast.net or whatever your site that you, or whatever account that you use to send your email, okay? And so what you want to do is, let's say I'm in all signatures up here on the very top. I want to add a plus, okay? And I see a signature 3 winds up there, okay? And I want to change that, and let's say I had 2 signatures, and I want to say, oh, this is from Dad, okay? So I just like to just put that in there so I don't have to write it myself. But I could put anything I like, okay? Maybe I want to put something like, have a nice day, all right? Some people like to do that, say, and very California, okay? And let's say that's okay there as well, too, all right? And then what I want to do is I want to make sure that my Comcast.net has that available. So it only has 2 signatures in it. Let's click that signature number 3 in the middle box here that we created. Okay, and put that in there. Now I got 3 signatures in my Comcast.net. So you can always remember to drag it in there. So remember to add something, click on that little plus on the bottom, and you'll get a 4th signature. Create your signature, and then make sure you drag it into your account. Okay, so that'll show up, and I'll show you where that's going to show up. Okay, let's go out of this box here. And our main menu. Okay, our main menu has mailboxes, has inbox, sent, trash. It'll have another one. Okay, if we want to draft something and save it, it's a draft. I'll show you how to set that up. And we have something called On My Mac where I create various folders. Well, let's create a folder. So you go down to the bottom left-hand side and click on the plus, and you'll see some things, and I would say new mailbox. We want to create a new mailbox. Okay, it's going to ask me with a drop-down box, what do I want to call it? I want to call it Automobiles. Okay, AUTOMOBILES. Make sure I got that spelled correctly. All right. And click OK. And I have an automobiles folder on my Mac section, okay, of my mailboxes. So well, I wanted it really at the bottom. Let me just click on it. I can drag it. So I can customize the way I want. Right? I can also customize this page. I can move this whole white area in here. This is where I'm going to get my emails. If I move it over too far, sometimes that might happen. You say, geez, I'm missing a lot of things. Well, just grab that edge there and just click it over till you get it where you like it. I can move this from to the middle and the subject on that side. So I can move a lot of things around in here. Date received, I can make it first. But I like the from right in the front, and I like the subject the second. So that's where I'd like to have it. Next thing we're going to look at is the toolbar. I don't have anything up here in the toolbar. And now we're going to add some things to the toolbar. Let's go up to View and go all the way down to the bottom where it says Customize Toolbar. Click on that, and a big drop-down window is going to be right in front of us. Let's click on something called Get Mail. We want to be able to get our mail. Let's put that. It's a click, drag, and drop. We also want to New Messages. Let's click that. Drag up there and put that in the toolbar. And I also want to delete items. Okay, I don't want to go up to the menu on here. I just want to have it on my toolbar. I want to be able to reply or forward items. Is there anything else I want to put up there? Well, maybe I want to print something. Okay, maybe I want to take some notes and put that up there. Okay? There's a lot of things that you can do and you can have up on that toolbar. If I really don't want something, let's say, you know, I really don't want to print anything off of here, or I don't want to have my notepad. Let's say I'll take the print and the notepad off. I take the print, drag it down, watch what happens. A little puff of smoke. Also, you could change the way it looks up here. Okay, and let me show you down on the bottom here in the left-hand side. If I click on those arrows, it says icon and text, icon only and text only. Okay, watch up on the top there on the toolbar, text only. That's all I have. Okay, I'm going to have icon only. I'll just have the icons. For me, I like to have the icon and text. I'm going to click on that. And that's on the bottom left-hand side, icon and text. I like that. So now we're done. Let's click on done on the right-hand side on the bottom. And we're out of the toolbar menu. Now let's go to toolbar and click on New Message. Okay? And you can see we have another toolbar that opens up here. So let's just look at that other toolbar right away, and let's go up to Edit, and I'm sorry, let's go up to View and click on Customize Toolbar on the bottom, and you have a whole new toolbar that you could add things to. You know how to add things to your toolbar and take them off. Okay. To menu, well, I added a lot of things in my address book, so let's add myself up here. I'm going to send myself something, and there I am. Okay. And if I click on the end of it, it just says my name. Well, if I say made a mistake and that's not really what I want, how do I get rid of it? Well, I bring my pointer over. And on the little right-hand side, you see a little white arrow. Click on that, another drop-down box, and I want to remove the address. So I click it, it's gone. So again, that's how you can kind of add and remove things up on two. Remember, I didn't click CC myself on anything, so that's just fine the way it is. And I want to send myself a automobile file, okay? So label that as file. Over on the left-hand side, your little drop-down box, and as you customize it up here on the top a little bit. And now we want to go over to the signature. Well, I don't have any signature here, okay, in the body. So let's click on signature. Remember, we actually created one. So in here, this is 1, 2, and 3. So signature 1, well, that's my Digital Road Films. Okay. 2, Well, that's one that says Big Daddy. Okay. And signature 3 says Have a Nice Day. So I can do anything I want. So for this exercise, let's just put signature number 1, Digital Road Films. All right. If I want to make it urgent, I can put high priority. You get a couple of asterisks up there, low priority, just a little line. Okay, you can do anything you want. A lot of customization. So now I'm going to say here, file attached. Okay, separate this a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to go up on the top in the toolbar and add an attachment. Drop-down box comes in. A little bit different than if you've just bought a Mac and have had Windows before. Same concept. You're going to go in and you're going to look for the files wherever they may be. So let's click on this file, this particular folder here, and let's go over to the bottom right and choose file, and it winds up on my page to be sent. And let's go up in the left-hand corner of the toolbar and send it. See? You can hear that sound. It's been sent. All right? So now, remember I said you don't really have to wait every 5 minutes or hour, however long you set when you want your mail to be looked at and brought into your computer. So I just want to get mail, so let me click on it and get it. There's inbox. Whoa, that was fast. There's one. Did you hear that ding? Okay, that's it. So now here's a mail that came on my front page. Let me click on that. And there's the file, and it says file attached. Okay, I can take a quick look at it. I could save it. That's small, 36 kilobytes. It gives me some information. Very nice. Now, I know it was an automobile file because it says subject automobile file. I've looked at it, and I want to save it in my folder I created that's called automobiles. Okay, so I just click on it. Okay, left click, drag, and drop it. And you could know you're on it because it's a little outline blue box, okay, around automobiles. See how that? And just drop it in there, and it's gone from my inbox. Let's make sure it's in automobile folder. Let's click on automobile folder. There's Jay Ernst automobile file. Let's click on that. There it is. All right, automobile file. Nice. So now let's see if I want to get rid of something.